In this session, I'm going to show you how you can run a criteria from multiple tables. In this case, three tables. We have the contracts table, the customers table, and the invoices table. They are all linked together. And I want to pull, let's say, the first name, last name. Those are from the customers table. Then the contract number, and that will be under contracts. And then the invoice date, invoice item, invoice amount, and whether it was paid or not, it is from the invoices table. Now, how we can pull a criteria like this, how we can run a criteria like this, and then also do some more things with this, whether the invoice was paid or not, and even create a calculated field so that if the customer did not pay this invoice, you charge them a late fee for it. So let's go ahead and design the query. So I'm going to close this and not save the changes here. So here's how you create the query from the three tables. We know that the tables are linked. Now we go under the query design here, and then we add the tables. So the first table, we can add the tables in any order, really doesn't matter. So I'll add the first one, go to the second, and then the third table. Then we click on close. Now let's say that the first field that we want in the query is the first name. Then we choose the last name, so I could double click on it. And then let's say I want the contract number for whatever reason, to, as a reference, I guess. And then we can choose here the invoice date, the item on the invoice, the amount, and then finally, if it was paid or not. By the way, you can make these bigger by just dragging it down. Then double click on paid or not, and then we can go ahead and run and see what this looks like. Click on run, and notice we have pretty much what we had before. So we have first name, last name, number, date, item, and then the amount and whether it was paid or not. Now, of course, we could go and arrange this in order, for example, whether it was paid or not, and then we'll go here under design view, either by right-clicking on it or just view here, then design view. And then we need to scroll to move this actually up. And then we can go ahead and order this in ascending order. Now, if I run it, notice they are not in order. Now, most likely they are not in order because we have another field that is doing the ordering. Actually, we chose the amount here. So let's go back and we wanted whether it was paid or not. So we choose ascending, run it, and now notice we have all the no's. Now what about if we want it to display only the customers that have not paid? Because these are the ones that we want to notify, and eventually we want to even send them a letter, tell them that there is a penalty or a late fee for the payment, that the invoice was not paid. So first, let's learn how we can actually limit only those that have not paid. So if we go back here under view and then choose design view, we can go here whether it was paid or no. Now remember from before, when we chose the customer city, we entered for example Lansing or Holland. Now in this case, we have a yes or no. So the invoice was either paid, yes, or not paid, no. So if before we entered the city name Lansing or Holland to limit it by, in this case, if we wanted those that have not paid, that criteria would be here. What we'd put in here would be just simply the word no, because we want to display these fields with customers that have a criteria of the invoice not paid or with a status of no. So now we run this and notice we have here just those customers. If I scroll down, there are no customers that have a paid invoice. Now, what about in this list, we do not even want to see the word no here or these fields no, but we want to display only the customers that have not paid their invoices. What you can do, again, we can hide this field. And if you remember earlier, we could go here under design view And by the way, I'm not right-clicking on it because we have not saved this query yet. So if I go ahead and choose to save this, so invoices, we give it a name. Now we can right-click on it and choose design view. So that's why I was not clicking on design view there. If I don't want to see the field no, I can just uncheck it here. It's still going to run it on that criteria, but it's just not going to display it. So notice we don't have that field. You'd say, well, why do I want this list? This would come in very handy for customers that have late payments. And usually, as most companies do nowadays, those that have not paid their $30,000 bill or more or less here, you want to charge them a percentage fee. So now in the next section here, we are going to learn how to calculate or to add another field here that will calculate the late fee. So here's how that is done. So we go into design view, right click design view or view and then design view on the top. And then we're going to add a new field over here. So to add a new field, what you'll need to do is you need to click on this builder icon here on the top. And then on here, what we are going to do is the amount. So the invoice amount, double click on it. And then times is the asterisk. Let's say we are going to charge 5%, 0.05. And then we click OK. Now notice it says here EXPR and it has all kinds of other stuff behind it. What we do here is we can type there, just leave everything alone, and right here where it's EXPR1, just that section, we want to change that to late fee and leave the rest alone. So if we go to the right here, notice it's doing the late fee, it's calculated the amount times 0.05. So then if we run this query, notice we just created another column that we added. So for this customer that has a $30,000 bill, the 5% comes to $1,500. So now the question would be, how can we format this? And by the way, that is how you create a calculated field in Microsoft Access. And you can look this part again in the video, just rewind it and see it again how it was done. So now we are going to learn how we can add here the dollar amount or make or format this field as a currency field. So we'll go back here under the query design and go into design view. And then what you do is there is a property sheet over here, an icon on the top right. Click on it. Go to the field that we want to modify the formatting for it. And notice it's giving us the properties for the late fee field or for the invoice paid field. Now notice for these other ones, like let's go to the amount here. The amount was formatted earlier in the table into the dollar amount. So now we are going to go here into the late fee and we're going to format this, click on the drop down, and we're going to format that into currency, to the dollar amount. And then the decimal places, you can specify those as well. So you can mark it at 2 decimal points. So now we can close this, the property sheet, rerun the query, and notice the late fee has been formatted as currency. At this point, we could save this query. We could actually even click on save up here, and that has been saved at this point because we had not saved it yet earlier. And if I close it, notice it doesn't ask us to save it again. Now, if I go here under and run this query quickly, notice I have all these late fees. What about if I wanted to get the total here on the very top for these late fees? And this is what we're going to learn next, getting the total for different fields. So let's go ahead and run this query again. Notice we have these late fees here. And now let's say that we wanted to see the totals in this query. So in the very bottom here, we want the total. So what you do is you click on it and then go to the home tab. And then there is this option here for totals. So we click on it, and then it's going to give us one more row in the very end for us to specify what totals we want. So let's say for the late fees, we want the sum here. And then also for the invoices, we click on the drop down and we want the sum of those invoices. So then we save it. And whenever we rerun it and those numbers change, those will be updated automatically. So if I go here under contracts and I modify, notice that this was the total here ended with 850, 1.3 million and 850. Actually, I needed to modify the invoices because that's where the invoices are pulled from. So the amount here, for example, it says 70,000. I go and change that to $1. As soon as I update this invoices amount, because again, the query was running from the invoices before, close this, run the query again, notice that has been changed. So now it's $1,839,851 compared to what it was before. So those are some of the queries. That's a limitless list of what you can do and how you can run those queries. I would say play with them, but this is the general idea of creating new fields, calculated fields. And by the way, you can go ahead and change the design here. And let's say that you want to charge them a 7% late fee. You'll notice that from 65,000, it's going to change when you modify that. So if we go back here to our design and we go to our calculation, so instead of 0.5, we make it 0.7% and then run the query again. Notice that from 65,000, now we have 91,000 in late fees. So check those out, and it's a lot of fun actually playing with the queries and generating all these types of data.